Broke girls are crying as pretty girl privilege is dying. It's crazy because with the soft guy era now firmly here, the privilege that women once enjoyed is beginning to dissipate. They're beginning to see that the Sims are not as valuable as they thought they were. Because just because she can go on Instagram, toss on a bikini, take a picture in her backyard, and post it up, and then have a million thirsty dudes in her DMs, so many guys that she can't even respond, nor does she want to respond to all the messages, and then think once she walks outside, every guy wants to talk to her. That reality is beginning to fade. She's beginning to realize that social media and the real world are not the same thing. Those guys in her DMs, many of them would never actually go on a date with her. Where are these guys in the world? When you actually quantify it, like you do the outright math, most of the guys in her DMs cannot physically go on a date with her. Okay? It's like something like maybe 10% geographically speaking, based on where she is and where they are, and then the likelihood they would actually go out. Because a lot of Sims are just there because they're thirsty. They're thirsty. That's it. And they're Sims. In today's world, especially, most Sims just want to have that safety of communicating behind a computer screen. They don't actually want to have real world interactions. When it comes down to the number of guys that will actually go out and interact directly with them, it's much, much smaller. And then on top of that, you know, the number of there's the percentage of men that she actually wants to interact with from that number of men. And then that's tiny. That's completely tiny. So her options are not really as large as she thinks. And a lot of those Sims just want, you know, to her to, you know, send pictures or, you know, very, very just things that are not good, you know, stuff that would essentially be degrading. Those people are not her friends. They don't care about her. You know, they're just a nice guy, but Sims are not really nice guys. They want something. Okay? And of course, we all want something. As a man, you should be more selfish. But Sims are basically just ick. Let's check out this video by Soraya. Of course, I have her linked in the description so you can check her channel out. But she kind of brings up a really good point in one of her videos where she says, am I wrong or right? Let me know in the comments. Do some women earn their position in a man's life? I think that's a very critical, that's a very fair thing to ask.
You know, I don't understand when some women be like, a man has to earn my femininity. If he doesn't do certain things, I'm just not going to be feminine. How do you just turn your femininity on and off? It really doesn't matter if you are with a machinist or with a man that makes six figures. Either you're feminine or you're not. You can't just turn it on and off like a light switch. And even if you do have this type of mindset, I do have a couple of questions for you. Is your body count low? Do you cook and clean every single day? Do you greet your man by the door every day before when he comes home? Do you know how to act accordingly when things are not going so well? Do you know how to follow a man's lead? Do you call your man bro? I can't stand women sometimes. They always request things, but then they just don't want to do certain things that are just basic activities. These are basic things. You should be doing this anyway.
Now, this is the thing. Just because a woman is feminine doesn't make her a good person. But that's a thing. That's fine. Femininity is a thing. It's a part of a woman's personality. It's a part of who she is. Just like masculinity can be a part of who a man is. In Western society, we have a lot of women who have lots of masculine energy, and that's a part of their personality. If you've spent your 20, 30, 40, 50 years of your life, you know, expressing masculine energy, giving off masculine energy and boasting about your masculine energy, and suddenly you want to jump into a relationship with a man because you realize that now men are saying they're not tolerating it, they don't want masculine energy around them, and you think that you're just going to put on a dress and some pumps and act like you're feminine. It doesn't work like that. Okay. And like, that's what the whole soft girl era thing is, where they're trying to pretend and act like they are soft and dainty, and they're wearing light colors, you know, light colors, and trying to pretend and trying to speak lower. And the thing is, like, they have these deep voices. They have these very, very deep voices, but they're trying to like speak slower and lower and pretend like they're like they don't know what's going on, like they're just little Miss Perfect. But the thing is, they don't want these women. They show their hand immediately because they don't want men. They don't want these men. They want to live. Soft girl era is all about living lives of luxury, comfort, and luxury. And the women who are doing this are the boss babes. Like, you know, I think Vanessa Law, for example, she's amazing. I think that she's taught a lot of people. She's helped a lot of people. She set a great example for entrepreneurs. You know, and if you don't know who that is, you should go check her out. She, you know, gives a lot of advice on building a business, building a brand on YouTube, even on Instagram. She's done a lot of work. And then she basically disappeared for 1 year. She took a sabbatical, you know, and closed her entire business down, walked away from a company that was making millions of dollars. And I know that actually, and the thing is, it damaged a lot of people because she had an entire team of people working for her, but, you know, listing her on their resume, and then she shut everything down. She shut everything down. And how many men could do something like that? How many men could build a business, build a brand, and then walk away from the whole thing, shut the entire thing down, and put all of those people out of work because you know what? That's just life. It's a sad and unfortunate thing, but that's the reality that what ends up happening. A lot of women cannot handle maintaining, you know, being a boss for the rest of their lives, you know. And now Vanessa is saying that she's in her soft girl era, but she's come back to YouTube and she's like, you know, trying to rebuild her business and rebuild her brand. And it's like she's like talking about balance, but it's really one or the other. You cannot have both. To run a business, you have to put in the hard work. You know, you're gonna have to put in the hard work. It's not that simple. Oh, I'm just gonna drop a video here or there. Oh, I'm just going to do it. No, it doesn't work like that. You cannot have both. You have to be. It's either you are the boss or you are not. I've seen videos by some people who are like, this guy only works 3 hours a week and he's pulling in $36,000 a month. You know, look at you. You're lazy. Be like him. Like, this is social media. Like, it messes with your head. It messes with your perception. And it's like trying to tell you that anyone could do this. You know, this is why you have women in Western society walking around and they don't have a dollar to their name. They don't have a dime to their name. They can't rub two dimes together. You're out here trying to bum food off men, and men are basically have caught on finally. You know, like these videos of one after another of men refusing to pay for the woman's meal when they go on a date, and the woman basically breaking down in tears because she doesn't even have the money to pay for her own meal. She can't cover the bill for herself. Dude is like, you're going to have to find your own way home. You know, she's like, no, you brought me here. You have to take me home. He's like, I don't want to have, no, I'm not. I'm not taking you home. I'm walking away from you. You're an adult. She's like, well, I don't have any, I can't get home. I can't get home. He's like, take an Uber. She's like, I don't have money for Uber. So you came out on a date with no money in your pocket, no money to pay for food, and not even enough money to get home. You have these videos of dudes telling women that, you know what, I'm not Ubering you home. I'm not Ubering you home. And these women are like, they end up walking blocks or miles because they don't have the money to cover a $15 or $20 Uber. They cannot cover a $15 or $20 Uber. They don't have that kind of money. There's no one who's going to walk at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m. in the morning in a very, very, what I would call dangerous area because you know, to save $15 or $20, unless that's literally the only money that they have, or they don't have it at all. Okay. Pretty like it's Pretty girl privilege is dying as a result of soft guy era. Hyperinflation, men waking up, a collective awakening of men. And, you know, things are only getting worse for women in, you know, 2023, 2024, 2025. It's not going to get any better. It's not going to get any better. Men are waking up and realizing that this is not it, and they're walking away. And they're saying, literally, if she wanted to, she would. They're taking all of the dialogue, all of the things that women used to say, flipping it on its head, and throwing it right back at them. Guys, don't forget, I have another channel called Angry, where I discuss gaming, anime, geek stuff, nerd stuff, real world stuff, or whatever else interests me. There's a link to it in the description of the video. Go check it out. Subscribe to the channel. Enjoy the content. And I also have another channel called Men Walking Away, where I release daily videos. And if you're enjoying the content on this channel, on the Angry Guy channel, and you want even more content like this, head over to Men Walking Away. There's a link to the Men Walking Away channel description of the video. Guys, real girls are crying as their pretty girl privilege is leaving them. It's flying out the window because men are not tolerating it anymore. I'm seeing it, guys. After what I've learned and experienced, it's a collective learning between all of us. You know, I share my experiences, but then I also learn from your experiences. This is, people are like, Angry, how are you doing it? How do you know these things? Because while many of these are my experiences, a lot of these are also your experiences. So if I take those experiences and I learn from your experiences, I'm gaining wisdom. I'm gaining wisdom. Smart men learn from their own mistakes. Wise men learn from the mistakes of others. That's what makes them wise. There's some people who are like, oh, you never went through it, so you shouldn't talk about it. No, that's how they try. It's the people who are still out there making these mistakes, right, that haven't learned their lesson yet, that are trying to silence other people because they want to keep, because they are so screwed up. That's what women do. Women would rather bring down other women with them than ever admit that they are wrong. Women women who've made the decision that they were gonna go to medical school, get these degrees, you know, become a boss babe, flex, and act like they were on top of the world, and they decided to, and they neglected starting a family in their 20s, or even in their 30s. They didn't have children. They went around saying that they were queens and all of this other stuff. Now they are in their 40s, and they're trying to do the whole soft girl era thing. And they have all this masculine energy, but they're going around trying to call themselves feminine and saying that they're ready for a man, and they want, you know, and children, and they want women to know that they can have it all. They can have the degree. They can be doctor whomever, but then at the same time also be a wife and a mother while they are single and miserable and sitting amongst themselves and still flexing on social media. And they're like, you know, there's all these men that want to talk to me. There's all these men, and I'm carefully choosing amongst them. Really? And you could just see the look of grief and defeat on their faces. But they cannot ever admit they're wrong because their ego is everything. Their ego is it's a very bad thing because their ego will destroy their lives. It has destroyed their lives, and it will drag them for the rest of their lives because they will keep on acting out and refusing to settle. They're looking in their Instagram and they're like, you know, they have a 23-year-old Chad in there who's like, you know, or Brad, who's in there, hey, what's up? Let me clap. And they're like, look at that. I'm a high value woman. I can pull a 23-year-old man. Bro, this is a broke. You can pull a brokey? like, sis, what are you talking about? You're pulling brokeys. You're not pulling high value men. You're pulling brokeys. These dudes don't have any money. These are brokeys. Brokeys. And, you know, the men that you're talking about, that you're celebrating, these are to the average man who's built himself up and worked on himself. We call these guys dusties, you know? So you're pulling brokies and dusties while you're calling men who've built themselves up, men who've worked on themselves, brokies and dusties, when in reality, y'all are the brokies, y'all are the dusties, because, you know, you have a medical degree, but then you also have $500,000 or 600 or more than $500,000 in student loan debt. You know, you went out and purchased a house that you couldn't afford. So now you have a house that you spent $1.5 million for. And you are $2.5 million in, you know, you're $2.5 million in debt collectively. You know, because we're talking about We're talking about the house. We're talking about the student loan debt, and then we're talking, and then there's all the other debt that we haven't discussed yet. You know, like the expensive Lamborghini, you know, that you purchased. So you like, what was that, like $300,000, you know? And that's just the car, you know. We're not talking about the shoes, the furniture, and all the other stuff, you know. And then sis, like, you're not even squared away with the IRS. Like, why would any dude jump into a relationship with you? And you're a boss, you're a queen, and you deserve the very best. And you are, you know, the same women who are dating men, older men when they were in their 20s, are now disrespecting men who date older men who are older in their 40s, dating women who are younger, and attacking women who are younger dating older men because they want these men, but these men don't want them. So even though they were dating these men when they were younger and had no money and they had no problem doing this, they don't want younger women to date these men, and they don't want these men to date older women. To date younger women, because they can no longer compete with these women. They had their time. They had their time in the sun. They threw it away. They were, you know, they are born millionaires. They become millionaires at age 18. Basically, they get their debt. They get their card at age 18. You know, their credit card at age 18, where they start charging everything. You know, they get everything for free at 18, and then, but they only have a limited cycle because it begins to decline as they get older. And as she's on her decline, a man is going towards his prime. So when he's in his prime and she's on her decline, she wants him in his prime while she's in her decline. No. She didn't want you when she was in her prime. So why would he want her when she's in her decline? Guys, let me know your thoughts on this, and we'll talk about it in the comments. Like the video if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you like the video, share the video. And just remember that all roads lead to MWA, men walking away. And cheers.